A single strident note from lead guitar rips out to crack the sultry night above Hong Kong. Four synthesizer pips attend the echo at their leisure. Clatter of distant pebbles from the rock face either side. The human stew is mewing massively behind me too, soon drowned. Then the peak emits another blast from lead to split the air between the tower blocks and shoot across the bay to mainland China, where the Guangdong Hills curve up behind the plains beyond Kowloon to form the back wall and the cheap seats of my natural auditorium. This second stroke is tweaked 3 seconds later, like the first, by a hiccuping pip from synth, a drip of fat that glistens at a jagged skewer's end. Another drip, another, and another, and another. Then again the heavy skewers twang as long as trains, four end on end, each double-shafted, splintered, spiked, corrosive black. Now the music dives to gain momentum for the onslaught it has so far merely fanfared, with a barrage of five battering rams of sound launched in turn, the third and fourth a double dare, aimed higher than the other three, the last one tailed by a cowlick of clicks like a pennon. Here the searchlights blaze and flood the stage. The screen lights up to show a long shot of the flames and all between. I see myself, a speck of black upon a central shelf of white, my back to audience and camera, growing larger by the second as we zoom in close towards me. Five more battering rams, again a tail and whine of feedback. As the camera streaks in closer, I prepare to turn. The viewpoint dips and lurches over valleys full of heads to frame my swelling silhouette against the screen. On screen, on screen, on screen, for an hour regress yawns and flickers round my static head and tunnels as I stare and am caught up with, through the peak, the sea, the ocean, to the ice and out beyond. Five more battering rams, then the drums explode in a lazy burst, cascade and land in rhythm on the beat they now inform both slave and master, pre-volcanic, unrelenting, like the metronomic bomb blast from the founders in the center of the earth. I turn to meet the swooping camera, gently smile at it, and spit. In fear, the human wavelets near the stage attempt retreat, but only bunch up into dunes. Central by the footlights, like a prompt box, is a monitor relaying for me what is up on screen. My face close up, my golden eyes triumphant, dark and lethal, burning level-gazed as if to scorch in double path the lightless wastes of Asia. Separate sectors of the multitude, as prearranged, are floodlit one by one, in direct echo of the movement of my eyeballs on the screen. The music has grown richer now and fuller than you ever thought it could be. I address not you, my angel. Dense as print, its layers and its columns, every sound in precisely the role I allot. The size of its ego, which is monstrous and beautiful, makes of it not a hemisphere that seeks to find completeness in your listening, but a sphere, well, nearly that, of quite vocational charisma, for your wonder, celebration, and resentment. It is rape, glee, destruction, assault with intent to engulf, as invitation to dance, unacceptable, for proffered by a giant too big to engage with. In any case, you cannot tell its sex. It appears to be male, but displays upon inspection several curious transcendences of gender. Your choice, then. Decline from the wallflower beds, or be swept up and carried where you never knew there was. You hesitate. The giant stoops to grab. You try to bolt. He claws you up. You struggle. He grips. You shriek. You feel the crack of breaking bone. You try to shout, but cannot. Whistling air? Then you smack into his shoulder with a crunch where you dangle, cling, and ooze, shitting blood and moaning faintly to the beat with a smile. But now beside you, from the giant's neck, as if a glint of steel were pushing out through the flesh to pierce the chitin and unfurl and cut the air, erupts a blade and locks itself. My voice at last. My voice has come to sing for your destruction. At its ruptured scream, the giant roars in pain, clutches vainly at this scythe that slices out below his chin to kiss the air in which it hardens as it twitches. Then he flounders on a swell of sound encroaching from behind, bogging down his every step. Glancing back in panic, he can see the music pouring from the peak, as if from its entire length the mountainside were belching out a glacier of blackened flesh and metal, flowing out above the stage across the jets, around my feet its shadowed outline, chewing sluggish teeth of sightless grated white like divers' panes, then out and down among the millions, inexhaustible and hideous as a vision out of Giga. The giant tries to run, but waves of darkness overtake. From their surface shoots a spume of treble sound, the jagged topcase of a carriage of immaculate complexity, whose lowest treads, articulated wheels of bass as never heard, on caterpillar tracks as tall as towers ride up over any barrier, with majesty inhuman, biomechanoid, insane. Down the giant is sucked and ground to splintered pulp, his size too great, unlike your own, for him to find a space to perch among the gears or on the tungsten flanges round the undercarriage edge. But there you nestle, You who toppled from the giant when he fell, where you squiggled and you bickered for the crannies, yes, you did. Cower now, then, and shake to hear that voice stride infernal and divine across the wastes of metal sky above the framework where you hide. For as it enters you, diffuses, throbs inside you like a drug you cut with ice and powdered glass before you shot it, every shriveled twist inside you will be infiltrated. Sternum, ribcage, heart, and eyes. My spider movements, legs are bass guitar. Its claws are snouts to rear and lick you where you shiver. A glimpse of sudden image of the singer on the monitor, his skinny leaping body as his echo thunders merciless, immense and redly gashing on the blackness of the music. My own voice and actions mate with his and ride upon him, cut him open, mingle with his blood, ram him through and flow around, assimilate him whole, to multiply elevenfold the ecstasy and agony he stirs. I see a close-up, shafting out across the multitude, my singing mouth, my eyes, my leering face, my open head and gullet, shrieking guts and arteries. Yelps of guitar shoot up the corners of the sky in branching clumps and flowering umbrella sprays of yellow. Bass shakes the bones in the boulders of the sea while the hills blaze hollow eyes and groan. Heads and bodies bubble in the distance all around me. Don't you hear me now? Don't you feel me down inside you, you before me, every one of you? Don't you kid yourself that you'll escape the damage I intend? I think you do, so watch me now. Lights weave and lash. You are wrapped, you are stunned, you are limitless and legion, tier on tier, as up the sides of a satellite dish. Through screens and speakers round the world, eye control, hour on hour, center stage, your collective fascination's poisoned cynosure. I drink the lurid limelight as a desert gasps for fluid, while a billion spotlight eyes are drinking me. My mesoveric voice resounds and soars and swoops and softly lacerates, omnipotent, relentless, for a night. As the vaults of heaven boom, the firmament reverberates. Hong Kong, the continent, the oceans, and the world at last are borne up and churned in a storm-colored vortex on the cyclone of the sound. Smooth as China now, its lesion, magnetic in its dominance, in power sublime. Your understanding stretches to its climax, stretches, stretches, clicks, snaps as its vertebrae dislocate under the onrush and floats on a plateau of jelly and air at the foot of a further scale of impossible peaks to stretch towards. Jangler blades in your head. Then the music implodes. The carriage disappears as black spaghetti through the mouths of the peak. Its echo dies, like a house that snaps and totters and collapses, to be sucked through a furrow in the carcass of the toad that rots and winks above the lift shaft in the earth below the cellar. Above the lift shaft in the earth below the cellar. I bowed my head a moment, turned and left. The stage was dark again,